Racist LeBron James just infuriated fans with disgusting thing he brought on the court for first game. And yet another professional sports organization is now intent on committing suicide. The NBA's opening basketball game between the Boston Celtics and Cleveland Cavaliers on Tuesday night has many fans wondering how the league will handle the ongoing protests from ungrateful players over what they believe is police brutality and racial injustice in our great nation. At the Tuesday night game, during the national anthem, the Cavaliers linked arms, while the Celtics bowed their heads. Although no one had the guts to kneel after an NBA leaked memo from last month had instructed players and coaches to stand during the patriotic moment. Although there really was no actual disrespect shown for our flag yesterday, the overpaid ignoramus LeBron James had to put in his 2 cents in by wearing a pair of shoes with a ridiculous message on it. Equality. Are you freaking kidding us? You are a multimillionaire who plays in a league where 78% of players are black, 17% are white, 4% are Latinos, and 1% are Asian, while the black population in the U.S. is only 13%? And you have the galls to complain about so-called equality? What the hell is wrong with you people? NBA.com reports. Cavaliers and LeBron James sign multi-year contract. The 2016 NBA Finals MVP re-signs with Cleveland after leading team to its first ever NBA title. Cleveland, oh, the 2016 NBA champion Cleveland Cavaliers and LeBron James have signed a new multi-year contract, General Manager David Griffin announced today from Cleveland Clinic Courts. "We are very fortunate to have a championship group together," said Griffin. "One that has grown organically to trust and sacrifice for one another, on and off the floor. At the core of that group is LeBron. His leadership, passion and tireless commitment are the hallmarks of our success and have inspired our entire franchise. His connection and dedication to his community and this fan base are absolute. We share his determination to win at the highest level and can't wait to get back to work, together to defend our title." James, a four-time MVP, 12-time NBA All-Star and 3-time NBA champion, appeared in 76 games, all starts, for the Cavaliers in 2015-16, averaging an Eastern Conference best 25.3 points, 5th in NBA, on .520 shooting from the field, 14th in NBA, 7.4 rebounds, 6.8 assists, 9th in NBA, and 1.4 steals in 35.6 minutes per game. It was James' 12th consecutive season averaging at least 25.0 points, which is a new NBA record. Previous was 11 straight seasons by Karl Malone from 1987-88 to 1997-98 and Jerry West from 1961-62 to 1971-72. James, the only player in 2015-16 to shoot over .500 from the field with averages of at least 25.0 points, 7.0 rebounds and 6.0 assists, was an NBA All-Star starter for the 12th straight season and All-NBA first-team selection for the 9th year in a row. He earned the Kia NBA Eastern Conference Player of the Month, the league best 3 times in 2015-16, February, March and April, as well as the Player of the Week award in NBA High tying 5 times, weeks ending November 22, January 10, March 6, March 27 and April 3. James started in all 21 games during the Cavs' championship run in the 2016 playoffs, recording 13 double-doubles, 2 triple-doubles, and averaging 26.3 points, 9.5 rebounds, 7.6 assists, a postseason career high 2.3 steals and 1.3 blocks in 39.1 minutes per game. In the 2016 NBA Finals win against Golden State, James, who was named Finals MVP, helped the Cavaliers become the first team in league history to overcome a 3-1 Finals deficit while leading the series in points, 208, 29.7, rebounds, 79, 11.3, assists, 62, 8.9, steals, 18, 2.6, and blocks, 16, 2.3. He was the first player in NBA playoff history to lead a series in every major statistical category. James is just the fifth NBA player to have three finals MVPs, joining Michael Jordan, 6, Shaquille O'Neal, 3, Tim Duncan, 3, and Magic Johnson, 3. The 6'8 forward scored in double figures in all 76 regular season games in 2015-16, increasing his consecutive double-digit scoring streak to 717, third longest streak in NBA history. In addition to scoring in double figures every game he appeared in, James had 63 games of at least 20 points and 18 games of at least 30 points. He also registered 28 double-doubles and 3 triple-doubles. After concluding his 13th NBA season with 26,833 career points, James climbed all the way up to number 11 on the NBA's all-time scoring list, passing Oscar Robertson, 26,710, Dominique Wilkins, 26,668, Tim Duncan, 26,496, John Havlicek, 26,395, Paul Pierce, 26,316, Kevin Garnett, 26,071, Alex English, 25,613, Reggie Miller, 25,279, and Jerry West, 25,192, this past season. He also moved up to 18th place in assists, 6,815, joining Oscar Robertson, 9,887, as the only players in NBA history to rank in the top 25 in both points and assists. The Akron, Ohio native remains the franchise's all-time regular season leader in points scored, 18,914, scoring average, 27.3, field goals made, 6,776, three-pointers made, 978, free throws made, 4,384, assists, 4,835, and steals, 1,168, while ranking third in rebounds, 4,842, and fourth in blocks, 580. Over his 13-year NBA career, James has appeared in 987 regular season games, 986 starts, with averages of 27.2 points, 7.2 rebounds, 6.9 assists, 1.7 steals and 39.0 minutes, while shooting .498 from the floor, .340 from three-point range and .744 from the foul line. For his postseason career, James has appeared in 199 contests, all starts, with averages of 28.0 points, 8.8 rebounds, 6.8 assists and 1.8 steals and 42.1 minutes per game. I'm guessing these fat cat players really don't understand where the money comes from. If you upset your fans, and your sponsors, the money dries up. Don't take my word for it, just ask your comrades in the NFL. Last year the NFL decided to let a player kneel because he was losing the spotlight when he started to play poorly and then it spiraled to the mess we have today. Their TV ratings are down, their sponsor money is down and their game attendance is way down. I predict the same will be happening to the NBA if this continues, since most working class folk don't care to be lectured about equality from a man who made his fortune just by tossing a damn ball around.